The degree of bloodshed in St. Louis caught nearly everyone by surprise. Monday, April 29th, 7 are shot, leaving 3 of them dead in just a 24-hour period. Then, the following weekend of May 4th, the bloodshed staggering as 2 are killed and 14 others shot in just one weekend. All the violence leading to questions on whether St. Louis needs a new approach to combating the shootings and killings. I caught up with St. Louis Public Safety Director Jimmy Edwards. He's over the police department.
Yes. Do you think this city is safer?
I think the city is much safer. The city is much safer today as it before last year, much safer before 2017.
People are seeing this seeming like an explosion of violence in the city. What does this administration have to say? Are your current plans working?
Well, I think the plans are absolutely working. We have significant reduction in violence and gun violence all over the city of St. Louis.
Edwards points out there are 10 fewer homicides than this time a year ago. There were 49 murders so far this year. That's compared to 59 a year ago. But that's not the whole picture. There were 729 shooting incidents this year. That's almost the same as a year ago this time, when there were 751 shootings. That's just a difference of 3%.
Every shooting is an attempted murder.
Well, unfortunately.
How does that sound safer? That's not much less than last year.
Well, unfortunately, we had many more non-fatal shootings in the last 4 or 5 years.
The city's going to have to make a change.
Lewis Reed, the president of the St. Louis Board of Aldermen, has been pushing for that change. He wants the city to adopt a crime-fighting program called Ceasefire.
We can't continue to do the same thing and expect different results. I'm not surprised by the result, right? There has to be a major change in course and direction.
The program that was once known as Boston Ceasefire started there in the mid-90s and had several key components. Incentives to get the most violent gang leaders to agree to a ceasefire. Troublemakers are channeled to programs to try to turn their life around through jobs and education, even helping them get off drugs. But if they don't change, law enforcement cracks down to get them off the streets and in jail. Boston cut juvenile homicides 63%. Other cities have used ceasefire or used modified versions of it to cut their crime dramatically.
It has been researched more than any public safety model in an urban setting anywhere in this country, right? They're now starting to pick it up and do it overseas. It works.
Do we need a plan like ceasefire? Some are advocating we need a whole different plan. They're pointing to ceasefire, saying that could cut homicides 50%.
Elliot, we have had this conversation several times. Mm-hmm. And ceasefire, we have components of ceasefire. I think every city in our country has a component or another of ceasefire.
Now, Public Safety Director Jimmy Edwards points out that the city of Boston doesn't even use Boston ceasefire any longer. Now, that part is true, but like many other cities, it does use a modified version of Boston ceasefire program to make it more effective in reducing adult homicides. That's what Lewis Reed wants St. Louis to adopt.